Ananda, this is Jaya Karamchandani, and today sharing with you some amazing money magic spells or rituals. But before I dive deeper into that, the amount of money that you have in your life or the amount of money that you want to manifest in your life, it is all related to how you think about money and how you feel about money. Surprised? And these rituals will help you remove those blocks from your thoughts and your feelings. How you feel or how you think helps you feel, and how you feel, that's how you're thinking. So leave the comment below and tell me, when you think of money, how do you feel? Do you feel rich? Do you feel poor? Or do you think of, I always have problems in getting money, I never find a stable job, money which my friends have more, not me, or money, it's a different feeling. And that different feeling needs to go away so that you feel fulfilled, so that you feel happier. The more you feel calm and in perfect harmony with money, the more money is going to be attracted towards you. Now, before I share that, I would highly request you, if you're enjoying this content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss the episodes that we share here. And particularly today's topic is on money. So the very first spell, anytime you are stuck in a situation where either you have lost a job or you have been demoted, and given the current pandemic, if you have lost the job or there's a struggle with money, your reality, if you want to change, you have to change your relation with money, and that block will be removed. You will be drawn to opportunities and opportunities will be drawn. Calm down, sit quietly, breathe, relax. And if you have a saving box, great. If you have not made, then start doing it. Or I would say every month when your salary comes into the bank account, withdraw something, even if it's a dollar bill or 1 rupee or 1 euro, put it in a box, stick that money with the intention that money grows in your life. Now, do this money mudra like this. And what you got to do is, in that saving box, which you just put your money, and this you have to do every month, take a sprinkle of cinnamon and sprinkle on top, or the dry ginger powder, either. Every month when you stick in that some money, that's your saving money. Think of your bank balance is growing. Think of your back is getting stronger, the secure money you have that you have set aside. What it does is it reprograms your subconscious and you start to attract opportunity where you are saving more. That means you have extra income. That means you have extra where you are saving. The second ritual, have a jar that you are setting aside the money for growth. Any day of the week will do, but I would say particularly in the morning, take a jar and in that, on a white piece of paper, write the need that you have for money. If you need a new job, what is the salary? Now, be realistic, we are not hitting a jackpot. It takes time, it's hard work. Take a piece of paper, write your money need and put it in the jar. Make sure it has a lid. And when you put that paper in it, keep on chanting, keep on repeating. You could be loud, you could be silently repeating that my life is filled with abundance. Everything happens for my own good. Keep chanting. Drop the paper you were chanting. Now take a bay leaf and write on it with red or green your name and stick that one bay leaf in it. And one coin, any coin, a quarter or a penny, a rupee coin, or any, just one coin, stick in it, close the lid and keep it in your home where you can see, but make sure it's not too obvious to others. The more you look at this jar, it will remind you that your desire for money, the need for money has been left to the universe, and it's in alignment with the universal desires, and it's going to manifest. It is reprogramming your mind. It is reconnecting you with money. It's your relationship with money that has to change, and your reality will change. I really would like your comments, so you share with me how you feel about it. I call it money magic spells because when you go through the dark phases in life and you feel that things aren't happening the way you would like, it manifests. And you would see how easy it is the minute you remove those blocks, change your relationship with money, your life starts to flourish. And the third spell, if you're enjoying this content, I would say please share this and share with your family and friends so their life flourishes and is filled with the same abundance. Now, throughout this process, if you notice, I'm sharing that be in harmony with money, be in harmony and calm down. So if you have to reconnect with yourself again, sit quietly, reconnect, and make sure you are focused. The third ritual, I would say, is whenever you are out and about, and if you have a bag, see-through bag is perfect. Red color, green or blue, get a bag. You can start any day. Like for if you're starting on Thursday, you take this bag, get shower in the morning, take this bag, and this is the ritual done for 7 days. So first day you drop in similar denominations of the money. Let's say if I dropped 1 rupee coin or 7 pennies first day, second day I dropped a quarter, third day you drop 10 rupee note or a euro bill. So same denominations but different money every day. On the seventh day, let's say when you stick in $7 or 750 rupees notes or 7 euro bills, after that you again make this money mudra and sprinkle a little lavender powder and then close it and stick it in your cash box where you are using the savings and money. This is like a money magnet. You can stick it in your purse also, but what happens, you take your purse to the restrooms and washroom and the energy starts to get diluted. This is the reason I would insist if you stick it in your cash box at home. Now, three amazing rituals you can call raining money or money magic spells or rituals, but what it does is it changes your reality. It makes you feel rich and the riches start to come to you. How your relationship with money is the big reason how the money comes to you and even it stays with you. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Would greatly appreciate if you share the episode, and until next week, take care.